Amigas, amigos,
friends, ladies and gentlemen,
celebro este encuentro con usted,
with you,
presidente
Trump.
Mi visita obedece,
my visit,
en buena medida,
to a great extent,
a la importancia que tiene, sobre todo
with the importance
en estos tiempos de
right now,
económica
in these times
mundial,
of world economic crisis,
la entrada en vigor del
the importance
tratado
of the
entry
into effect of
entre México,
the Mexico-U.S.-Canada agreement to
Canada,
make by Spanish acronym USMCA.
El haber conseguido este acuerdo,
having been able to close this deal
representa
constitutes
un gran logro,
a great accomplishment
beneficio
benefiting
de las tres naciones,
all three nations
y de nuestros pueblos,
and our peoples.
Como es sabido,
as it is well known,
América del Norte,
North America
es de las regiones
is
económicas
one of the most important economic regions
del planeta.
Of the planet.
No obstante,
however,
nuestra región,
our region
es
inexplicably
deficitaria,
a region of trade
en términos
deficits
comerciales. Exportamos
we export
al resto del
to
mundo
the rest of the world
about $3.6 trillion, pero importamos
but we import
4,000
about
190 billones de dólares.
$4.2 trillion.
Es decir,
that is,
mantenemos
we
un
have
déficit
a deficit
de
611
millones de dólares,
billion dollars,
lo cual se
which
traduce
is translated
en fuga de
into
divisas,
capital flight,
menores oportunidades
less opportunities
para las empresas,
for companies and businesses,
y pérdida
and job source
de fuentes de empleo.
Losses.
El nuevo tratado busca precisamente revertir
seeks to reverse
este desequilibrio
this imbalance
mediante una mayor integración
integration
de nuestras economías
of our economies
y mejoras
and
en el funcionamiento
in the functioning
de las cadenas productivas
productive chains
para recuperar
to recover
presencia
the economic
económica
presence
que ha perdido
North America
América del Norte en las últimas
last
cinco décadas. Baste señalar
suffice it to
que 1970 la región representó
constituted
el 40.4% del producto mundial.
GDP.
Y ahora
now,
esta participación en la economía global
global economy
ha bajado
has gone down
a 27.8%. Por ello,
that's why
el tratado
this agreement
es una gran opción
is a great option
para producir,
to produce,
crear empleos,
create jobs,
y fomentar el comercio sin necesidad
trade
de ir tan lejos
having to go so far away
de nuestros
from
hogares,
our homes,
ciudades,
cities,
estados,
states,
y naciones.
And nations.
En otras palabras,
in other words,
los volúmenes de importaciones
import
que realizan nuestros países del resto del mundo
to the rest of the
pueden
world,
producirse
may be
en América del Norte
in North America,
con menores costos
at a lower
de transporte
cost,
con proveedores
reliable,
confiables
reliable
para las
suppliers,
empresas
reliable,
y con la utilización
course, and the utilization
de fuerza de trabajo
of regional
de la
labor
región.
Force.
Desde luego,
of course,
no se trata de
it's not a matter of closing
mundo,
our countries
sino de aprovechar
to the world.
Todas las
it's a matter of taking advantage of all the advantages that we have because we're neighbors, as well as the enforcement
de
of a good policy
para
of cooperation for development.
Este tratado
this
permite
agreement
inversiones
allows us to attract investments from other places of the hemisphere,
países,
bringing those investments to our countries, provided
con los
we comply, we honor the principles of producing merchandises
regional,
with high regional content,
procurar
and
condiciones salariales
also trying
y laborales
to have salary and labor conditions that are fair conditions for our workers of the exporting or importing countries of consumption goods. It's also important to
este
point out that this agreement
significa
signifies
la integración los tres países
the integration of all three countries
aportamos
because we're all contributing with productive capacity, markets, technology, experience, expertise, highly skilled labor force, and we end up complementing each other.
For
instance, Mexico has something which is extremely valuable to make this economic integration effective and to boost this integration, economic and commercial integration in the region. I'm talking about its very young, creative, and responsible labor force. Let us not forget that the participation of workers in productive processes is just as important as the role of businesses and companies. It really would be no good for us to have capital and technology if we don't have good workers that are outstanding workers because of their imagination, their talent, and their mystic when they do their work. On the other hand,
con acuerdos como este,
with this type of agreement
y con respeto a nuestras soberanías,
respecting our sovereign
states,
instead of distancing ourselves, we are
juntos,
deciding, we're opting to walk together towards the future. We want to privilege understanding.
Lo que nos une,
that's why we're united.
Hacer a un lado las
and we're setting aside differences, or we are solving those differences through a dialogue and mutual respect. Certainly, in the history of our relations, we've had perhaps moments in which our minds have not been
no
together,
olvida,
and there are. There have been problems that are not yet forgotten. However, we've been able to establish explicit agreements of cooperation and coexistence. For instance, in the 40s of last century, during the Second World War, Mexico helped meet the needs of the United States in terms of the raw materials needed by the United States, and it gave its support with the labor of migrant workers that were known as the braceros. Since then, and until now, we've been consolidating our economic, commercial, trade relationships, as well as our very peculiar coexistence. Cohabitation, sometimes as distant neighbors and other times as very affectionate and close friends. And it is also well known, history, geopolitics, this neighborhood we have and economic circumstances of both of our nations have promoted in a very natural manner a process of migration of Mexican men and women coming here to the United States. And here, we've been able to create a community of about 38 million people, including the children of Mexican parents. It is a community of good working people, good people, working people, who have come here to make a living in a very honest fashion, and they have so much contributed to the development of this great nation. Furthermore, in Mexico, more than in any other country of the world, we have in our society 1.5 million of U.S. citizens. They live there and they're part of our society. So we're not just united by geographic proximity. We have economic, commercial, social, cultural, and ties of friendship. President Trump. As in the best times of our political relationship, during my mandate as President of Mexico, instead of remembering this insults or things like that from against me, we have received from you, President Trump, understanding and respect. Some people thought that ideological differences would inevitably lead to confrontations. Fortunately, this has not been the case, and I believe that towards the future, there will be no motive or need to break our very good political relationship or the friendship between our two administrations. The best president Mexico has ever had, Benito Juárez García, as you have mentioned, had a good understanding with the great Republican president, Abraham Lincoln. Let us remember that this great historic leader of the United States, who was the promoter of the abolition of slavery, never recognized Emperor Maximilian imposed in Mexico through the intervention of the powerful French army. It is no coincidence that Juarez lamented Lincoln's murder in the United States, saying, I quote, I have deeply felt this disgrace because Lincoln, who was constantly working in such a determined manner for the complete freedom of its fellow men, was worthy of a better fortune or luck. End of quote. The same thing happened with the splendid relationship that President Franklin Delano Roosevelt had with our patriot President General Lázaro Cárdenas. The same situation took place. And after the oil expropriation, in a letter, General Cárdenas recognized the good understanding, the good bilateral understanding as follows. He said, my administration believes that the attitude of the United States of America in the case of the oil company expropriation reasserts once more the sovereignty of the peoples of this continent that with so much effort been maintaining and the situation and the position of His Excellency, Mr. President Roosevelt. End of quote. So, with all proportions and all the circumstances, with different circumstances, history tells us that it is possible to understand each other without arrogance or extremisms. Now that I have decided to come to this meeting with you, President Trump, we had a good debate in my country on the convenience of this trip. I decided to come because, as I have already expressed, it is very important for us to be launching this new agreement. But I also wanted to be here to thank people of the United States, its government, and thank you, President Trump, for being increasingly respectful with our Mexican fellow men. And to you, President Trump, I want to thank you for your understanding and the help you've given us in issues related to trade, commerce, oil, as well as your personal support for the acquisition of medical equipment that we needed urgently to treat our patients of COVID-19. But what I mainly appreciate is that you have never sought to impose anything on us, violating our sovereignty. Instead of the Monroe Doctrine, you have followed, in our case, the wise advice of illustrious and prudent George Washington, who said, quote, nations should not take advantage of the unfortunate condition of other peoples, end of quote. You have not tried to treat us as a colony. On the contrary, you have honored our condition as an independent nation. That's why I'm here, to express to the people of the United States that their president has behaved with us with kindness and respect. You have treated us just as what we are, a country and a dignified people, a free, democratic, and sovereign people.
Que viva la amistad.
Long live the friendship of our two nations.
Que viva
Long
Estados
live
Unidos
the United States of America.
Que viva Canadá.
Long live Canada.
Que viva nuestra América.
Long live our America.
Viva México.
Long live
viva
Mexico.
México.
Long live
viva
Mexico.
México.
Viva México.
That's fantastic. Beautiful job. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. President. Great job. Thank you. And we will now sign a very important document. Thank you. Thank you.